6.
1 and 2.
God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble.
I rock the rock, 'cause God rocks the rock, and if you're
God made promises to his children thousands of years ago. He made promises to you. God said that he predestined you and foreknew you while you were still being formed in the innermost parts of your mother's womb. God said that he has plans to prosper you, plans to give you a future. God said that nothing can ever separate you from his love, not the past, not the present, nor that which is to come. God said that he promised to never leave you or forsake you. God said that he is always ready to take your burdens upon himself and give you peace. God said that he guarantees forgiveness of sin. God said that he loved you so much, he gave his only son as a sacrifice for you. So the next time you're wondering what you have to be thankful for, stop and think about what God has done for you. And give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to The Rock. Give me a moment. I'm going to look to see who has already joined us. Hi, Rock friends. I see your names popping them already in the chat. So happy to see you.
We're so happy to see you. Are you happy to see us? We have a wonderful, exciting service plan for you this morning. We know you're going to enjoy it. We love you. We thank you. And we want to worship with you. Welcome to The Rock Children's Church.
All right. Let's have fun.
What time it is? Do you know? It's time to connect to God together by singing and moving to music. Even though sometimes I may not feel like dancing or singing, it's not about how I feel. God deserves all of our worship all the time. He deserves our best. He deserves all of our thanks. So get up and let's connect to God together.
Hands together, come on! How many times has God ever lost?
have your BFF, which is your Bible, your friends, and your finances, which is your offering. Don't forget to like the video because we worked hard on it.
Hey, Alyssa, guess what time it is?
It's time to give our tithes and offerings.
Are you ready to give back to God?
Always. And while we do that, I wanted to answer this tough question we got from our friend Colin. He writes,
"This is kind of hard to ask, but what if I don't have much money to give to God?"
I'm so glad you asked, Colin. Sometimes it can feel like we don't have much to give God.
But, you know, God doesn't care if your gift is small.
He just cares about our hearts when we give. He loves a good attitude.
He wants us to obey Him by giving a tithe. So we give 10% of our money to God first, even if it's a small amount.
It might seem like God would only be happy if you're giving a gigantic stack of money.
The Bible talks about a woman who didn't have much money, but still gave an offering.
God saw how much it cost her to give that little bit. He was impressed by her giving heart, not by the amount of what she gave.
Even when you give a small gift, God can use it to make a big difference.
God knows our hearts and loves to see us giving and being obedient. Thanks for that awesome question, Colin. And thanks for giving.
Because giving is a great way to
share what you have and put God first.
Hey guys, Luke here.
And Alyssa, and we have mail.
Yeah, a lot of mail.
I can't wait to read them. Okay, here we go. First one first. Ooh, two things. Okay, you can have that one.
Okay.
Dear Connect crew, I love Connect, and I really want to live for God. Here's a picture of me with my backpack. I got ready for school on time, and my mom and dad didn't even have to tell me to. Love, Tate.
Way to go, Tate.
That's so awesome. Oh. God loves it when you do the right thing, especially when you don't have to be told. So good. I can't wait to read all the rest.
Okay, you're gonna have to wait though, because it's time to
rehearse the verse.
Today's verse is found in the book of John, chapter 4, verse 23. Say it like this. John 4:23. True worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Great, now I'm gonna say it and you guys repeat after me, okay?
Okay.
Are you guys ready?
Oh, they're ready.
Okay. John 4:23.
John 4:23.
True worshippers will worship the Father.
True worshippers will worship the Father.
In spirit and in truth.
In spirit and in truth. Great job, guys.
So good. Okay, another letter. It's pink.
Ooh, you're favy.
Okay, let's see. La. Dear Alyssa, that's me. I really want to go to a citywide worship night next Friday night, but I can't go without a trusted adult. Will you go with me? Love, Abby. Did you hear that?
Yeah, I did.
Worship night. I love worship. Next Friday. Man, I have to work a shift in the hub next Friday night. Do you think Ray would let me go?
Well, you could just ask her.
Oh, I know. I could ask her.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to say to her.
Please, can I go? Please, please, please. It's worship. It's really important. I know it is, but I make the work schedule based off the needs of the whole crew. We can't just change it whenever we feel like it. But Abby really wants to go. Abby really wants to go. Okay, fine. I want to go too. Please, please, please let me go, please. I have to think about it. Pretty please with sprinkles on top. Okay, fine. Take the time you need. I hope Ray lets me go to worship night. I know. I'll remind her just how important worship is. And then maybe she'll let me go. Yeah. Abby, if you're watching this, pray hard. I'm working on it.
Hi, Alyssa.
Oh, hi. La 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 la.
Is there something you'd like to ask me about?
Oh, no, no. But I mean, there is something I want to show you, but I mean, you're working, so it's fine.
Okay, great. Hey, just tell me.
Okay, so I was thinking about how important worship is to God. I mean, it's God, so we have to worship him, right? So I was like, I wonder if the Bible has anything to say about this. And so I started his own Bible research, and what do you know? Sure enough, the Bible does say something about it. So I know how much you love the Bible. I mean, duh, it's God's word. I love the Bible. We all love the Bible. So I mean, you love it, and then
Alyssa,
I love...
Alyssa, how about you just show me?
Okay. All right, let's see. Ha! Here it is. All right, you asked for one Bible story about worship. Coming up. You're gonna love this.
This is a 66 picks mixed up into one. The books about God, who he is and what he's done. It's the Holy Bible, y'all, with God's truth packed tight inside. It's alive, of Christ to hide in your heart and in your mind. Old Testament's a setup for the big event. When Jesus crashed the scene with a new arrangement. It's history, his story, whose story, God's story. Oh, the story of how much he loves me. Let it blow up all the pages, let this show go live. Let his word explode from this video into your life.
It was a scorching hot day. Jesus was traveling and stopped in Samaria to rest. Under the hot sun, Jesus sat by a well. He was thirsty and hoping someone could help him get a drink. Soon, a woman from Samaria came to the well to draw water. Jesus asked her for a drink. The woman was too shocked to give him water because Jesus was Jewish, and Jewish people did not talk to or hang out with Samaritans. Jesus said,
"It's okay. If you really knew who I am, you would be asking me for water."
"What? You don't even have a bucket. How could you get me water? Hang down into the well by your feet and get water by the handful?"
Jesus could see she was confused.
"Everyone who drinks water from this well will be thirsty again. But I have come to share a living water that will satisfy your thirst forever."
Living water? On a hot day like this, it sounds too good to be true.
"Okay, please give me this living water so I won't be thirsty anymore."
Then Jesus said something she wasn't expecting.
"It's not just water you're looking for. I know that you are lonely and thirsty for friendship."
She had never told anyone about her loneliness. How did this man know this? He seemed like a smart man of God, so she decided to ask him a question that had been on her mind.
Sir, Samaritans worship on a mountain. Jewish people say we should worship in a temple. Which one is the right answer?
Jesus answered her.
That's in the past. Soon, true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Anytime, anywhere.
I know that Christ the Messiah is coming soon. I'm sure he'll explain the rules to us when he gets here.
Dear woman, I am the Messiah.
The woman could not believe her eyes. The same man who asked her for water, knew everything about her, and told her she could worship anywhere, was the Messiah. She was so excited to tell everyone that she had met Jesus that she'd left her water jar behind at the well. Because of the woman's story, the Samaritans asked Jesus to stay with them. So Jesus stayed for 2 more days, sharing his good news with them.
See, God is looking for those who will worship him in spirit and in truth, so you know it's really important to him.
Hey, you're right.
That's right. I'm right. So does that mean I can go?
It means you've given me something to think about. Thanks, Alyssa.
You're so welcome.
The Bible has a great deal to say about worship, which brings us to today's point. Friends, say it with me in 3, 2, 1. I'll worship God with all my heart. Very good. Perhaps our friends will discover this point very soon.
All right. After I finish this install, it should boost our broadcast signal to where it will reach even more kids in the most remote places.
That's great news. Nice job, Mike. Hey, Ray. Do you have a second to listen to this story that I wrote?
You wrote a story. All right, let's hear it.
Once upon a time, there was a girl named Alyssa. Wrong. Once upon a time, there was a girl named Princess Alyssa.
So the story's about you.
Shh. Princess Alyssa's heart was broken.
Oh no.
Oh yes. Her heart was broken because she had sinned and done things her way instead of God's way. Her heart was broken because her friendship with God was broken.
Oh, I see. That's terrible.
It is. She tried to fix her broken heart by herself. First, she tried to get people to like her. She thought that if people liked her, she would not have a broken heart.
Did it work?
Nope. Then she tried collecting things. She thought that if she got everything she ever wanted, clothes and toys and candy.
Somebody say candy? Ow!
And a giant tiara, then she wouldn't notice her broken heart. But nothing worked. Then Alyssa learned about God and how he made everything, including the stars and the moon and the Milky Way galaxy, and how God made everything in the whole universe. Most of all, she learned of God's great love for her. Princess Alyssa learned that God loved her so much that he sent his son Jesus to save her from her sins and fix her broken friendship with God. So Alyssa prayed and asked Jesus to become the leader of her life. Princess Alyssa started following Jesus. God fixed Alyssa's broken heart, and she promised to worship God with her whole heart.
Aww. That's such a great story.
I'm not finished.
Of course you're not.
One day, when Alyssa was on Connect Station, a girl asked her to go to worship with her one Friday night. Alyssa asked Captain Ray if she could go, and Ray, God is big and powerful, and he's done so much for me. That's why I love to worship. So how does the story end? Can I go, please?
Please! What?
I got your back.
I know how important this is to you. And you're right. We should give God all of our worship. I have a decision I need to make. Come on, let's go.
Okay. To the room.
Hi, room.
Hello, Alyssa. Hello, Ray. How can I help you?
Alyssa wants to go to a worship night.
How wonderful.
But I have to work in the hub that night.
I know worship is important, but we need her here, and what we do on the station is worship too. So, I have a decision I need to make. Room, can you show us today's verse?
John 4:23. True worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth.
In spirit and in truth. I wonder what that means.
Jesus said it in the Bible story.
Worshiping in spirit and in truth means worshiping God with your whole heart for who He truly is.
And we do that here all the time.
Ray, you're right. I love to worship, but I worship all the time here on the station. I don't have to go to worship night. It's okay.
Look, I understand why you want to go, and I know you and Abby will have fun. So, I've decided. I'm going to cover your shift. You can go.
Oh, Ray, really? Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And I promise, I'll worship God with all my heart.
I'll worship God with all my heart. It looks like you've discovered the point and connected the dots.
Well done.
Well, we better go. You've got a worship night to get ready for.
Thanks, room.
You are both very welcome.
Did you hear? Did you hear? I get to go! Abby, get ready because we are about to worship! Woohoo!
Are you going to worship with parts of your heart?
No!
I'm gonna worship with all my heart!
That's how you worship. You know what? Let's say the point together, huh?
Okay.
I'll worship God with all my heart.
Oh, I can't wait to go. I wanna go right now.
Well, first, say the verse with me.
Okay. You guys say it with us.
John 4:23. True worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth.
Great job! Abby, if you're watching this, I'll see you Friday night!
And I can't wait to hear all about it when you get back.
Until then, remember to worship God with all your heart.
Show how much you love Him.
It's gonna be so much fun.
I know.
Sing and dance and praise Him. It's gonna be so good. I'm so excited I get to go to the worship night with Abby! I'll worship God with all my heart. And not just on worship night. I'll worship Him every single day, all the time. God is incredible, powerful, and He loves you so much that He sent His Son Jesus to save you. He alone deserves our worship. If you haven't decided to make Jesus the leader of your life, you can do that today. Just remember ABC. A, admit. Admit that you've done wrong and ask God to forgive you for disobeying Him. B, believe. Believe God sent Jesus to take the punishment for your sin. Trust that you're forgiven because Jesus made you right with God. C, choose. Choose to spend your whole life depending on God's power to help you say no to sin. As you live and love like Jesus, tell others God is your leader and number one friend. If you choose Jesus, please let us know. Talk about it with your Connect small group leader before you leave.
That is good news, Rock friends. And we no longer have to be bound by the devil, but we can be free in Christ Jesus. Who's excited about that? I am. I'm so excited. And you know what? Becoming a child of God is so easy. You know what? All you have to do is say a sincere prayer. Mean it from your heart and believe it. Okay, so I'm going to lead you. I just want you to follow me. All right, are you ready? Let's pray together. Say, Dear God, I admit that I have sinned, which makes me a sinner. I now believe that Jesus Christ came and he died and he was raised to life for my sins, for the sins that I committed. I confess Jesus Christ as my Lord. And that means no longer making decisions for myself, but asking him, what should I do with the life I've made? And you say, amen. Can you do that? Great job, Rock Friends. Let us know that you've made that decision. Reverend Moshe is going to tell you how you can connect with us and share that decision you've made.
Rock Friends, if you made that decision, we are so excited and we're celebrating your new life. You are a brand new Christian and we are so grateful and so honored that you made that choice. Well, if you want to connect with us here at the Fountain of Praise, you can get your adult and they can go to tfop.org and there is a connect tab which will give you information about how you can become a member of the church. And there's also a tab if you want special prayer that you can click on and get special prayer. So we would love to hear from you and your adult and your parents if you made that decision. And so that's how we can connect with you. Even though we can't connect with you physically right now in service, but we can connect with you virtually. And so we just celebrate the decisions that you've made. Well, Rock Friends, did you enjoy our services today? Miss Lanessa, did you enjoy the services today?
I had so much fun.
We know that many of you are going back to school. Some of you have already started back school, but we pray that you will be able to go back to school in the rest of the summer, knowing that God loves you even though you make mistakes and that you can continue to build your confidence. Well, friends, you know how we like to close out our services. If you're not already standing, we want you to stand, place your finger on your forehead, and receive your blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift his countenance towards you and give you peace. See you soon.